Hello, my dear students, how are you? I think all of you are well. Now I would like to discuss on chapter 2, computer network, in this in my today's lecture. We will learn about, can you guess anything? This picture showing arrangement of something in specific order. So in computer network, we have one term like this. This is network topology. In network topology, we can arrange the computers in different way. This arrangement of computer is known as network topology. Now the term classification of network topology. As I said earlier, as there are different way of connecting computers, so there is the classification of topology, and these are bus, ring, star, tree and mesh. And by combining any two or more, we can have another topology like hybrid. And then see the picture. Clear? What is this? This is bus. And what is the main use of bus? It carries the people or human being in our real life. But regarding computer, these are the buses, these are cables, and we all know these cables can transmit data. So in bus topology, there is a cable at a central location, then the computers are connected with this bus. That is why this is known as bus topology. See another picture. From this computer, data is arriving and it reaches to all the computers. There is no discrimination. All computers are equally important in bus topology. That is why the signal is being received by all the computers equally. Then I'd like to discuss in details about bus. So what is bus topology? The topology where all the computers are connected to the main backbone or main line, which is called bus. And these are the advantages of bus topology. All the computers have equal importance, that I said earlier. Failure of one computer does not affect the whole network. It is very cheap and it is very easy to add and remove computer to and from the bus. It has also some disadvantages. If you increase number of computers, then huge data traffic jam may occur. It is not efficient technique and make network slow. Full network will collapse if the bus is damaged. So this network is depend on the bus. If bus is active, then whole network will be activated and you can smoothly work. Then ring. In ring topology, computers are connected in a circular way, like the picture. And this is the routing process. Then data will be moved from in this circular path. See the example, another example of bus topology, sorry, ring topology. Then what is ring? A circular path used to connect in which data travels around the ring. Data continuously circulate till arrive the particular destination. That means if you send data for one computer, until it reaches the destination, it will be circulated among the ring. An advantage, it is low cost. All the computers have equal importance like bus. Efficient technology for less number of computers. That means if we work with less number of computers, then ring topology is good. Disadvantage, full network will collapse if one computer disconnects. We can say failure of one computer affects the whole network. It also decreases speed if number of computers is increased. Adding new computer is very complex. Then star topology. In this topology, you see the picture. There is a central device. In this central device, all the computers are connected. So In definition, we can say the topology where all the computers are connected to a central device called hub or switch. So hub and switch, hub or switch is the central device on which the computers are connected to make a bus topology. Advantage: faster in data transmission. Add and remove computer is very easy. Failure of one computer does not affect the whole network. Fully depend on hub or switch. Network will collapse if hub and switch fail. These are the disadvantages of this topology. Now comes tree topology, and please observe the picture. Here is the backbone cable and all the computers, not single computers, but the section of computers like star shape are connected to make a complete tree topology. Now see the definition. The topology where the network is established against a backbone cable treated as root of the network, that I say shown in the picture. It is the extended form of star topology. Branch computers are connected to the backbone. Sub branches are also connected to the branches. Easy to add a new computer. Advantage: if leaf nodes are disconnected to harm, no harm happened to the network. That means if we remove any one single computer, then it will not affect the whole network. It is very complex. These are disadvantages: very complex structure, very costly, hard to maintain. If the server damages, full network collapse. If the computer damages, all the computers under that is disconnected. So network is partially deactivated. Then mesh topology. In this topology, all the computers are connected with each other, and there are two types. Sometimes the computer, all the computers are may not connected with each other, then this will be a partial mesh. And if all the computers are connected to all the computers, it is called complete mesh. And so how many connections are there, we can calculate by using this formula. Note down this formula into your copy. The total connection equal n into n minus 1 divided by 2. Here n is, n represents total number of computers, and you see 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 5 computers, and if you can calculate 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So by using formula, we can count there are total connection is 10. Then advantage: faster communication. Since all the connected directly, reliable. It is very reliable since computers are connected by multiple path. Reliable in this sense, if one path is deactivated, then communication will be possible by another path. So this is reliable. Even one computer is disconnected or unable to work, no hamper occurs in the network. Disadvantage: costly because of huge cable, complex structure, hard to add new computer in the network. Then write down the homework into your copy, and you must bring the homework in the class when the class will be resumed. Thank you very much. Thank you all.